Students, now we will see FSK demodulator. FSK demodulator means you are going to extract the information signal from a modulated waveform, which is modulated in terms of frequency. Okay. Now in this also we are having two types. One is called as synchronous demodulation, which is called as coherent detection. And another one is called as asynchronous demodulation, which is called as non-coherent detection. So first we will see the first method, which is called as synchronous, which is coherent detection of BFSK signal. Now in this, the input over here will be a BFSK signal and the output has to be binary data. That means from a modulated carrier, which is varied in terms of frequency, we have to get a binary data at the output. So here, first we are going to give a BFSK signal, that is a carrier signal, which is modulated in terms of frequency. That carrier signal is going to this channel and this channel both. Now in this also you see a correlator 1 and in this you see a correlator 2, which is a combination of product modulator and integrator. Here also you are having product modulator and integrator. This circuit is synchronized with locally generated frequency by the oscillator F1 here, which is given to this modulator, and F2 here, which is given to this modulator. So if the input frequency is F1, that is representing binary data 0. If the input frequency F1, this will go through this channel and this frequency will match with that F1, and this circuit will give an output X1. This circuit will give output X1. Similarly, that same input, which was frequency F1, if it goes to the down channel, it will not match with this frequency and this output X2 will be 0. When 0 and this X1 comes here, the output is X. X is nothing but X is equal to X2 minus X1. So if X1 is having a value, then X will become a negative value. If that negative value passes through a threshold device where it is compared with the 0 voltage, the output will be 0 because X is less than 0. That means the variation of input here, whatever we had F1 frequency, that is going to give you output as binary 0. Similarly, when the BFSK signal is having frequency F1, that means it is going to indicate binary 1. That frequency will go here also, it will go to this also. Then at this channel, it is not going to match with F1, it is going to match with F2 here. That means X2 output will become a positive and X1 will become 0. That means X will be positive here. If X is positive and that if it is passed through the threshold device, then the output will be logic 1 because the X is greater than 0. That means this output is going to give you binary data for the input of frequency variation. That means this is a demodulation of binary frequency shift keying circuit. Students, now we will see the second method of asynchronous, that is non-coherent detection of BFSK signal. So again here, the input will be a frequency variation of the carrier and the output has to be binary data. But here, you don't see locally generated oscillator, because it is not going to synchronize anything. It is not going to synchronize, so you're not showing any locally generated oscillator. So what we have here, channel 1 and channel 2, we are having first as a bandpass filter, which will pass only a frequency F1 here, and the second a channel, a bandpass filter, which will pass frequency F2. Because here, the BFSK signal will be having variation of F1 and F2, which will indicate binary data 0 and 1. So if the binary data is 0 and if frequency F1 is going to come here, that F1 will pass through this bandpass filter, but that will not pass through this bandpass filter. That means this channel will work. Now in this channel, we are having a circuit called as envelope detector, which consists of a rectifier and low pass filter. Rectifier will remove all the negative half cycles and low pass filter will pass the DC line. That means this output X1 will come out as an envelope of this signal. Similarly, this X1 when goes to the subtractor circuit, then when the frequency here was F1, that means X1 will exist and X2 will not exist. That means the output X of the subtractor will be x is equal to x2 minus x1, where x will be negative, and when that negative passes through our threshold device, and when it is compared with the 0 volt, then output will be 0 because x was less than 0, it was negative. Similarly, when this BFSK signal is having frequency F2, that time it will pass through this section and this section will not pass it. So once it passes through this section, the rectifier and low pass filter will give you output X2 will be coming here for the subtractor, and because this input is not coming, X will be equal to X2, that will be a positive value, and when the positive value is compared with the 0 volt in the threshold or device, the output will be logic 1 because X is greater than 0. That means here the output will be binary data for the variation of frequency in the input. That means you have done a demodulation of FSK signal. This is the second method of FSK demodulation.